You're welcome once again to St. Mary's Dedication British National School, International High School online class. So today we're going to be focusing on surveying and planning of farmstead, the subject agriculture, and this class is for the senior secondary school 2 and 3. Now the contents, we're going to be focusing on the meaning of farm surveying, the importance of farm surveying, common farm equipment and tools, the meaning and importance of farm planning, and we'll be looking at what is a farmstead and farmstead layout. Now, let's start with farm surveying. Now, for example, if I go on, if you notice our houses, when they were building it, you notice you hear maybe your parents talking about a plan. There was like a book where the plan was drawn on how the house was going to be built. And this same rule applies here. It has to do with like the architectural part of agriculture. So it is like planning how they're going to build a farm structure. So farm surveying may be defined as a process by which measurements are made on the farm, and such measurements are represented by tables, plans, and layouts for specific purposes. It involves measuring and mapping out the position, the site, boundary of an area of farmland. So you get a farm, what they are basically talking about is getting a farm, then taking measurements about the different parts of the farm. Look at this diagram here. Measurements are already sitting here, 100 to 200, 100, 150. So they measure like the space between, for example, the drainage and the grain storage, the differences between the sheds, the cowpea area, the milking area, how the farm is going to be built, how the structures are going to be apart from each other. So these are just measurements. What is the distance between one building from another? This is basically what we're talking about. Let's go to the next slide. Now, importance of farm surveying. Why is it important that there is a plan for building a farm structure? Why is it important that you measure, take measurements? Now, so farm surveying is of great importance to farmers because of the several benefits that can be derived from having a farm survey. Now, one of them, let's look at them closely. It helps the farmer to know the area of the farmland. It helps to know how much space was used, the measurement, the land mass that was used. It also helps to produce farm map. So when this structure is built, it helps to create a farm map. So anybody can just come, use the farm map to locate the different parts. Maybe if he wants to go to where the silos are, where food is stored, he knows where to go. If he wants to go to the farmer's house, he knows the direction to take. Now, farm surveying is needed for the registration of the farmland and the issuance of certificate of occupancy. Now, in land, there's what they call certificate of occupancy. It's something, it's a title that is attached to land. This helps the farmer to give evidence that he is the owner of this farmland. So it is needed for the registration. They register the land because it is built on the land. So they have to register this farmland, and that is the beauty of farm surveying because it can give you a certificate of occupancy and all that. Now, farm survey, it can be used as collateral security for loan from financial institutions. So through this farm survey, you can actually use it take loans from banks. By showing the plan, you show the bank that you are serious and you have built a farm or how to expand your business. It gives you a level of integrity and seriousness, because when they see that you have a plan, they see that you are not someone who just wants to borrow money and they take you seriously. Now, it exposes the brilliance of the farmland and it helps you determine the best farming practice to be adopted in the farm. So when there is a layout, it's easy to detect what farm practice is to be adopted, what steps that you can take to ensure that crops are easily cultivated and they grow and become very productive. And it helps in the determination of the scope of the land, which helps in determining appropriate erosion control measures. So with the plan, you help, you also are able to put into consideration building things for erosion, you understand, to control water, because the truth is there's the rainy season and rain will always fall, and if there's no erosion plan, the water can destroy the farmland. So when you build, when you have a survey, it helps you to create a plan for erosion on how the water will flow when there is too much water due to rainfall. Now, common farm equipment, farm survey equipment. Basically, this has to do with things that you use for your farm, things that you use to make measurements, effective measurements, accurate measurements, in order to build and plan effectively. So, some of them are ranging poles, like this is the diagram of a ranging pole, arrows or pins, measuring tape, the crossbar, the prismatic compass, offset staff, beacons, cutlass, pegs, field notebooks. So these are things like this range pole helps you to give distance. From here, from one point to another, maybe the distance will be 20 centimeters, 30 centimeters, 100 centimeters. That helps you to accurately plan, because you use the ranging pole, you put it at a point, use your measuring tape, you measure how long, if it's 150, you measure 50 centimeters. When it's there, you put another ranging pole. So measuring tape and all that. Now these are also other diagrams for the different types of survey. This is the cross staff, which is used for 90 degree measurements of the land. And these are arrow pins too, which is used to mark out measurements that you have made. Maybe you've made some measurements and you don't want to forget where you made those measurements. So you just put those pins at the point where you have made the measurement. Okay, so ranging pole, it says it's made of wood or metal. That's one that was shown earlier. It's about 6 feet in height. It is usually painted black, red, or white, like that one was red and white, to enable it to be seen from afar. They paint it like that so that if you are far away, you can know that there is a ranging pole there. Okay? Alright. Arrows and pins. These are thin pointed metals which can be stuck into the ground. It's 30 centimeters long with one end curved into a ring. A red flag or flag. If you remember the diagram, you'll see that there is a flag on it, a red flag. It's attached to the ring so that it can be seen from afar. They are used during chaining, for marking out chain lengths as measured. They are used for marking stations. The measuring tape is known as the surveyor's tape. You know, for example, people that build, they have this measuring tape. Even tailors, that tape they use to measure clothes. They also use it here to measure the farmlands. Now, the cross staff is an instrument of the vibes, which was shown earlier. It looks like a cross, that's why they call it cross staff. It has this cross sign on both sides. Okay? This is an instrument or device which allows right arrows to be set at reasonable accuracy. Two forms are available. One is a frame with sighting slits at right angles. The other form is a form of a cylinder. Both are mounted on rods when used. Offset staff, this is a graduated rod. It's about 3 meters long. A hook might be fired at the top of the purpose of pulling the chain through and a hedge. It is used for taking offset measurements. Offset is a small perpendicular distance from the chain line to the point of detail where it's required to be plotted. Now, the meaning and importance of farm planning. Why is it important to plan? In life generally, it's very important to plan. So also in farming, it's very important to plan in order to get your goals and targets realized. So farm planning is a diagrammatic representation or arrangement for the layout of farm building and structures and the various enterprises. The plan shows the positions and areas of different farm enterprises, roads, farmhouse, and other structures if the plan comes to operation. Farm planning is important for the following reasons. One, it ensures efficient management of the farm as it helps in decision making. The truth about it is, when you are able to plan, it helps you to make better decisions. Okay, should we plant plantain this year? Should we plant cocoa this year? Should we plant cucumber at this point of the month? Should we plant oranges at this point of the month? Farm planning helps you to effectively do the right things at the right time. That is the beauty about it. Now, the plan is useful in the assessment of farms for loans to farmers. So with the farm plan, it's the bankers or the creditors can put into consideration. Is this farmer worthy of this loan? Is he worthy to get the money required? Maybe the farmer might say, I need a 10 million naira loan to run this project. I need 20 million, I need 30 million, I need 5 million, I need 3 million, depending on how big the plan is. So the farm plan, when the creditors sit and they see that it's a big project, it makes them decide, okay, let us approve this loan, or let us approve a grant to such a person. Now, a well-planned farm ensures good location for various farm buildings and structures. When you plan, you now decide where the farmhouse is going to be, where the storage houses are going to be, where the place for keeping animals is going to be. The farm helps you plan well, because after the plan, it helps you just decide where you put different structures, and also it creates room for space for new structures. That's the beauty about it. So good. It helps to determine the amount of input, such as labor, seeds, fertilizers, etc. It does not allow wastage of land, it helps to determine yield or productivity. So with the plan, you are able to predict, you are able to forecast. Okay, at the end of June, we are supposed to get this. At the end of September, we are supposed to get this. By December, the end of the year, we are supposed to expect so-and-so profit. Okay, with the plan, it helps you to determine how much are we going to make every month, how much are we going to pay staff, how much are we going to spend for maintenance, how much are we going to spend for every miscellaneous thing that we'll be doing on the farm. So, even as individuals, it is good that we too be planned to also make the right decisions and predict outcomes or results that we're expecting. Thank you. Next one. Now, what is farm stand? What is a farmstead? So, farmstead just talks about the different structures that are found on the farmland. It refers to buildings and structures and different types, such as barns, sheds, pens, and others found in the farm. The farmstead is both a home and a production center. So, the farmstead is something that it's a place where the farmer stays and the farmer does his business. So, it's a home and it's a production center. So, most cases, in a very good farmstead, the farmer is living there and is producing to reduce cost, because in such cases, it won't be effective if the farmer has to go home, come back, and it's too far from where it's staying. So the farmstead makes provision where the farmer can live and also make effective work. Now, for the farmer, dwelling house, farmer, barns, crops and seed storage houses, swine pens, so where you can keep your farm animals, where you can keep your crops, service buildings such as farm shop, farm store. So it has a store also, when it's well planned, it has a store also where as he gets the harvest, he can project it for sale. So in that farmstead, it also provides room for marketing, where you can just sell whatsoever thing that you have harvested. It's so nice because the farmer doesn't, it's like a mini country where it just provides for the life of the farmer. The farmer can stay there for as long as he can, even stay here maybe without really coming out of that environment. It's that content. Processing houses for crop products. So he farms, he makes products and all that. So that is it. In developed countries, for example, they can, from here, from a farmstead, you can produce milk that can be consumed by consumers right there in the farmstead. Now, this is a diagram of the farmstead layout. What is this talking about? It's talking about how everything was built, how everywhere was planned, how the structures were arranged. It talks about the arrangement of a farm. So, like this is the gate, this is the feeding area, this is another gate. Sometimes they make 1, 2, 3 gates for emergency purposes. Maybe if there are many people and they need other exit points, they create many gates. And sometimes they create gates for just safety reasons, basically. Now, this is the pre-milking area. Maybe the cows can be here where you go, the staff can go and milk the cows and all that, the robotic poultry areas. All right, this will be. Now, this is concerned with the arrangement of farm buildings, like I said. and structures in the farm site. This can be done according to a well-made master plan. So farm planning is very important to do a very good farm layout. Good layout often depends on the nature of the farm business. It might be a poultry, a cattle, pigs, or crop business like a plantation. In arranging a farm layout, the following factors must be considered. So before laying out a farm, before designing, some factors have to be very much considered. Now, location of the farmer's house, the orientation, the direction of the winds. The way the winds are moving, it also helps to, you observe the winds, how it's moving. It helps you to determine how you will play out the farm. Is it coming from the east? Is it coming from the west? Is it coming from the south? It helps you to plan that. Saving of time and labor. The buildings and structures should be located close to each other so as to reduce the time taken moving from one place to another. Cost of transportation has to be minimized. So they do it in a way that the structures are not far from each other. Fire protection. So it is designed in such a way that if there is a fire outbreak, the fire cannot easily spread. So maybe the silos or the barn is burning. They design the buildings in such a way that the fire cannot spread from one barn to another, or one silo to another. Or maybe, unfortunately, God forbid, if the farmhouse is on fire, the man, even though he loses his house, he doesn't lose his business because it is from the business that he can build a new house. So, fire protection. Fire should be far apart. Fields should be far apart from each other in order to prevent fire spread amongst the structures. And the soil type. Buildings should not be constructed on very fertile land. For example, the farmer is very conscious of the soil there. So he builds on places that are not so fertile. And he makes sure that such places too are not clay infested. Because if you notice, clay swells a lot, it gets stronger. And if you build there, the clay can disrupt the foundation. It can shake the foundation. And when the foundation shakes, it becomes disastrous as the building can collapse. So the farmer considers that he looks at the soil before he builds on it. He looks whether this soil, is it loamy soil? Is it clay soil? Is it sandy soil? Those are the things you consider, even while your house was built. So that is it. So thank you so much. I'm supposed to register, so we'll be talking to you. See you soon.